Hello everyone, today I'm going to be doing a tutorial on the Hello Purr app in MIT App Inventor. Before we get started, I'm just going to do a quick demonstration of what the app should look like. So here's the app on my screen, and the first page is the password page where you can submit a password, and the password I set is 1234, and once you hit submit, it's going to take you to the second page with a picture of a cat and a text that says pet the cat. And if you click on the picture of the cat, it should play a meow sound. And that is the app. So now I'm going to move on to do a tutorial on how to build it. So to get started with the app, we want to be in the Create Projects part of the MIT App Inventor, which should look like what I have on the screen. And we want to first make sure that we're on the correct user interface. To do so, we're going to click Settings, User Interface Settings. Make sure you have Neo selected and press OK. Once we've done so, we're going to click this button on the top left side. Go over to Hello Purr Starter and click OK. It should bring you to this page where we can start building our app. So the first thing we'll need to do is add some components onto our screen. And to do so, we're going to go to the left-hand side, drag in a label, then drag in a password text box, and last we're going to drag in a button. We want to make sure that these components are centered on our screen, and to do so, we're going to go to the right-hand side, click on screen one, go under Align Horizontal, click Center, Align Vertical, and click Center. And it should look like what we have on screen one right here. Now we're going to edit some of the texts for the components. So first we're going to click on Label 1. We're going to go down to Text and enter your password. And we're going to want to make this font a little bigger by going to font size and making it 36. So now we have the enter your password, we have our password text box, and we want to change the text for our button. And you can click on button one, go under text, and just click submit. And it should look like what we have here. And this is all we're going to need for our first screen. Now we want to create the second screen with the cat image and the text. And to do so, we're going to go up here where it says screen. We're going to click this plus button and click OK. It should bring you to this new blank screen with nothing on it. And to make the cat image, we're going to want to drag in a button. Then head over to the right-hand side. Make sure that button is selected. And we're going to go to image, click on that, and click on the key.png. And this is going to ensure that the image is on the button. And we're going to want to get rid of the text that's on top of the cat image by just clearing out this box that says text and make sure there's nothing in it. We're also going to want to drag in a label under the cat image and change the text to pet the cat. We also want to change the font size to 36 so that it's more readable. And we also want to make sure that this is aligned in the center of the screen. To do so, we're going to click on screen 2, align horizontal center, and align vertical center. And so now we're going to want to make sure that there's something that the sound can play out of, and that's going to be on the left-hand side. We're going to go down to media, go on sound, and drag it over the screen. You want to make sure that it's over the screen since this is a non-visible component, so we're not going to physically see it on the screen, but it's going to be down here in sound. We want to make sure that the sound is connected to the meow, so to do so, we're going to go over to the right-hand side. Under source, we're going to click meow.mp3 and click OK. This is all we're going to need for the screen components, and we're gonna go and now do the blocks of the app. And to do so, we're going to click on screen one. In the upper right hand side, we're going to click blocks. So for the first screen, we want to make sure that when the user clicks submit, that the password is correct, and then we'll move to the second screen. And if the password isn't correct, we're going to reset the password text box so that the user can try again. In order to do so, we're going to go to the left-hand side, scroll down to button 1, and drag in the when button 1 click block. So when the button is clicked, we're going to want to make sure that the password is correct. To do so, we're going to go over to control, drag in the if then else, and put it into this block. So if the password is correct, we're going to go to logic and drag in this equals block and put it in the if. Then we're going to go over to password text box 1 and get the text in that password box, which is going to be this password text box 1.txt block. Drag it into the equals block. Then we're going to go over to text, go all the way up and drag in this empty text box. And we can set this to whatever we want our password to be. Mine is going to be 1234. So if the text box text and the password are equal, we're going to move on to the second screen, which is in control. And we're going to drag in the open another screen, make sure it goes to screen 2. Else, we're going to reset the password text box text by going to password text box 1, going down and setting password text box 1 text to an empty text. So this is all we need for the first screen. Now we're going to move over to the second screen. And when the user clicks on the cat image, the meow sound will play. And to do so, we're going to go to button 1. And when button 1 is clicked, going to sound 1, call sound 1.play. So this is all that we need for our app, and now we can connect to it by downloading the MIT App Inventor companion app. And I'm going to move over to screen 1, click connect, AI companion, and you can just scan the QR code with your companion app. So here I have the app on my screen, and I'm just going to do another demonstration. So I'm going to click on the password text box. I'm going to first enter in an incorrect password, just 876, and when I click submit, you can see that it cleared the text box because it wasn't correct. Now I'm going to enter in the correct password, and it should take me over to the second screen, and if I click the image, it should play the meow sound. So that is our app. I hope you had fun building it, and we can think about ways we can expand the app. So maybe adding in different animal pictures with different animal sounds and picking a random one by creating a list of all those animals and using the random picker. We can also make the app look a little nicer by playing around with the fonts, colors, other fun things. There's a bunch of ways that we can expand our app. And if you want to think more about that, it could be a fun activity for you to do. But I hope you had fun building this app, and I hope you build some more App Inventor apps.